Hi, this is Alex from PHP Academy and welcome to this video on error reporting and how we can turn it on. You might be receiving no errors at all on your page, and this might be because you have error reporting set in a very specific way that doesn't actually output any errors, which isn't very useful when you're trying to debug an application. So we're not going to be looking at the error reporting function within PHP in this tutorial. Sort of want to make that clear at the start. We're going to be looking directly at PHP's initialization file and how we can change error reporting within this. So this is the way to go if you're working locally and you want to, you know, turn on some really strict error reporting or off altogether if you want the opposite effect for any reason. We're going to be looking at within php.ini, and then, you know, error reporting is something that you can, you know, go ahead and look up on php.net, and you can do this, you know, from your script. It's always a lot best though when you're working locally to turn on the strictest error reporting. It just gives you that extra warning, or them extra warnings that, you know, when you go ahead and upload to a public server, you don't get any surprises, because you'll often find that when you pay for hosting, the php.ini file will be stuck, you can't change anything. So you want to go ahead and make sure you're getting all of these warnings out from your PHP code. So we've got our php.ini file open in here. I'm using XAMPP, which, you know, is a package that automatically installs Apache and MySQL and everything for you. So you would find, if you're using XAMPP, and I believe it's the same if you're using WAMP as well, in /XAMPP php.ini. So it's basically wherever PHP is installed, or whichever directory it's installed within, or wherever the files are contained within, php.ini will be found. And obviously you can go ahead and do a search on your PC for the file as well. So the php.ini file, if you're not familiar with this, I'd go ahead and sort of have a look through it, see what kind of settings are available. Try and use a text editor that highlights things, because as you can see, all these green bits here are all comments, and then you've got the odd, if we just scroll down, the odd setting turned on here, or the property value. But we are specifically in this tutorial looking at error reporting. So I'm going to go ahead and Control F, so search, however you're doing this, whichever text editor you're using. I'm going to go ahead and search for error underscore reporting. And you can see here we're down to some kind of weird section here. That's not quite right. Let's go ahead and hit F3. And you can now see we are looking at the error reporting property, which, as I've said, can be set from PHP, but we're looking at it more sort of directly in here. So if we scroll up a bit to where we have this error handling and logging header, probably would make sense to go ahead and read this if you haven't already. It gives you an insight into, you know, all of this as well. It gives you an insight into the settings, the different, you know, well, as it says, error level constants, or just, you know, the different levels of error reporting. You've got things like eAll, which it says here it's commented includes eStrict, which if you come down you can read about eStrict itself. You know, there's tons of different things in here, but eAll is probably what you would want if earlier when I was discussing outputting absolutely everything. So things like warnings, so for example, undefined variables, as it says here, non-fatal errors, which means that your application will still run properly, everything will work, but it will just tell you things about undefined index, undefined variables, you know, things like that. Or if you're looping and you're incrementing a value that hasn't yet been set, you might get an undefined variable warning out, you know, things like that. So there's various levels of reporting. These are all really, really well documented at php.net. I think it would be beyond the scope of this video to go ahead and explain them all. But the main thing is to be able to actually specify them down here, and it says here common values. We've got some common values in here. At the moment, by default, well, especially with my installation through XAMPP, it's eAll eStrict. So I could, for example, just say eAll or eAll eStrict. So, you know, this is basically telling me any errors, or every error that possible that, you know, I could possibly have out. There's loads of different things you can play around with. you know, you've got everything here really. You can apply, you know, a combination of these or stick to the default things like eel, eat strict. So really this is, you know, preference. It depends on how far you want the error reporting to go. Okay, so once you've decided on what you want to be, you know, shown to you in terms of error reporting, you can go ahead and change these values as required. Obviously, we've got different symbols here that mean different things. So in this case, it means eel and, so we're saying and, exception here. So basically, this is an exception. We are showing all errors except for this particular here. And obviously, these can be switched around. It doesn't need to just be this. It can be eel except, I don't know, e-warning, for example. You know, it could be absolutely anything. So, you know, you can combine these here as well. And as the default setting that we've got says here, show all errors, warnings and notices, including coding standards. So anyway, once you've picked a level of error reporting, you're going to want to go ahead and modify this value, obviously. Then what you need to do is you need to go ahead and you need to restart your web server. So depending on what you're using, I'm using Apache, which is part of the XAMPP installation. It's just an easy way of installing, you know, Apache, MySQL, PHP all together. Then you go ahead and restart Apache. You can do that using your XAMPP control panel, your WAMP. Oh, I've got an error there, but your WAMP control panel, or you can use your system services controller if you've got Apache installed as a service. So there's, you know, this is common knowledge when you're working on local server that you should have already, but go ahead and restart and these settings will be taken into effect. Obviously this is our PHP initialization file, so when PHP is loaded through our server, these settings will be taken into effect. And then go ahead, try and force an error in your page and see how that outputs. So this has just been a quick tip on how to set different levels of error reporting through php.ini, which is the recommended method. Personally, I'd recommend this method as opposed to using the error reporting function in PHP. So that's how to set error reporting in PHP.